really looking forward to it. We got Shuring Steed Sports. Can we restart that?
Yeah.
The 2022 Championship Off-Road Series is finally here. It's a new year with some new exciting sponsors and a new video series too. I'm here to give you all an inside look to Kyle's race season, so subscribe to follow along. The Pro 4 and Side-by-Side are prepped and ready to go for practice this morning and qualifying later today, so welcome to Antigo.
Gonna run the buggy through tech and get it passed and get it back to the pits, and then Austin will bring up the truck and we'll run it through its tech, and then we'll be ready to go out and practice and do qualifiers this afternoon.
Yeah, can you hear me?
I can barely hear you, but yeah, it's good enough.
So you got that new helmet. What other new stuff, new team you got going on this year, new sponsors?
Yeah, really looking forward to it. We got Shuring Steed Sports. Can we restart that?
Yeah.
The SSS is
Shuring Steed Sports.
Yeah, Shuring. I need my hat though. We're back, take two. Yeah, for Champ this year, Shuring Steed Sports took us on board, and we got Yokohama, Air Force, Ames Oil, Milwaukee. We got a great group, a great team, and I'm looking forward to this year. This is gonna be the first round we practiced today. Practiced this morning and qualified this afternoon. We got a really good truck, side by side's really good. You know, Can-Am's still on board with me for now over a decade. It's awesome being here representing them also. That's about it.
And you got a fresh new helmet.
I do, got a sweet new wrap on the helmet. No wrap, it's a paint job. This dude painted it in like one day. Like, I sent it to him 3 months in advance and he didn't even have time to overnight it. He had to meet me on the freeway.
Santana, yeah, run it back, turn the lights on when I hit up Green Lantern. Yeah, fly the bras, fly the dogs down to Atlanta. Yeah, in the cut in Medusa, lay low, yeah, I might be. Yeah, roll up, help me calm down when I'm moving high speed. Yeah, if I send one, need to text back, cause you know what I need. Oh, please.
Yep, it's actually up here.
How'd your practice go, bub?
Good, good. Felt good. The truck and side by side, everything ran good. I couldn't see over my hood in the truck, but
we're gonna see if we can fix that.
I have a hard time seeing because my pads weren't like high enough. How about you guys? What do you guys think? It's not about what I think, it's about what you think.
This is your series, but I'll give my opinion.
Yeah, I want your opinion.
Looked pretty badass. The pro lights were crazy.
Yeah.
Did you see any of that?
No, but I heard a couple of them wadded up.
Yeah, it was wild. The pro 4, the trucks were badass.
Badass, yeah.
What'd you think of the track?
It was different. Say the least. I ain't gonna talk shit, but it was not great. I mean, we all have to drive it, so.
Was it the jump section, the doubles?
They were a little off, but I mean, like, it's hard to, they don't really have any timing, like flow. I don't know, it was fun. Anytime you're driving a Pro 4, it's fun.
So practice is done. What do you got going on until qualifying?
Pretty much just go over everything on this truck because it pretty much beats itself apart, and make sure it's ready to go out again as soon as possible.
In the side-by-side, we had the fastest lap in the truck. Me and Carlson were exactly the same. CJ was 0.4 faster, and LeDuc was 0.6. So I don't know, I feel like we're right there. Still got a lot to learn, but definitely feel better in the truck this year than I ever have. Yeah, I definitely haven't been that confident in the truck ever before. So when I'm in the truck now, it almost feels like I'm in the side-by-side. You know, my side-by-side, I'm just comfortable driving, and now I'm comfortable in the truck. So looking forward to this year. Plus, you know, we got Austin scraping mud. That just makes me feel good. I love the drink.
Why you gotta get me like that? She's the last one out to get this dough. No way, love one of your bucket-headed hoes. No way, hit the streets, then we break the code. No way, hit the brakes when they on patrol. That's just not.
I don't know. Definitely. Oh my god. You got a nice flex going there with your left arm.
Do I got a pump on?
Yeah.
Make sure you're filming.
I am.
Okay.
I don't know what that muscle is right there by your elbow, but it looks nice.
Okay. Well, it's there. Ask the girls about my muscles.
Which one?
Exactly. That's just not.
Turn one, it laid over, and I saw the smoke.
It broke the tire, broke the car.
But he didn't have brakes the whole time. He was pumping brakes the entire time. And he didn't, he was off the entire, he said something in the vehicle was off. Like he was off, he couldn't hit any marks. He couldn't do anything. So something was off, and he's like, I don't know what it was, but I said, well, your wheel laid over.
Are they towing him back or what?
No, I told him to boom him back.
Boom him back, yeah. Okay.
But no, he literally said in, on the radio, he's like, no, I just felt something was off. Right. It wasn't in him. He said something was off in the truck the whole time. He's like, I didn't have brakes. I was fighting that, but then I also, something was off. And then in turn one, I watched it lay over a little bit, and right when he's exiting turn one, it went over.
Let's see what the caliper mount looks like on the hub, since the hub's still in the truck.
That don't look right, does it?
No.
Yeah, but that's from maybe bouncing?
Yeah, maybe.
Where does that bolt to? The hub?
Yeah, there's another plate on the back that like sandwiches the bearings.
So then is there nuts on the back side of this?
No, it's the plate's threaded.
So these thread through?
Mm-hmm.
So it ripped them out. That doesn't even make sense.
Well, I mean, what's the chance that all six bolts came loose that were Loctited?
Yeah, and they can't go out that way.
And they all came loose?
Together?
Yeah.
In a unison? we can't do anything in unison, let alone get our bolts to back out like that.
Set. And after a couple laps, it got worse and worse and worse, and finally it just fucking just went to the floor. I'm like, oh, that's not good. And then I like started going towards the wall. I was like, holy fuck. I didn't even know the tire was gone at that point.
Oh, she was gone.
Oh, yeah, there.
I turned my head right as it happened, and I was like,
boy, like sent me towards the wall, and I'm like, holy fuck. And I just like turned and floored it to try not to hit the wall.
That was a good save.
It was, yeah, everybody's down there. Like, that was a great save. I don't know what the fuck happened.
I think you're pumping the brakes because the wheel bearing came loose, and then
that
they just
sense.
Kept resetting the pads back.
That's probably, yeah. Yeah, that makes sense now, because I was like, I took off and I was having a problem setting the truck because I'd hit the brake and it wouldn't be there, so I'd have to pump it, and then I'd get brake pads,
yeah.
I'd get brake feel, and like it just kept getting worse and worse, and like finally I just had to keep probably 4 or 5 pumps before I would even do anything. So I was just like, I knew it was coming, so I'd just pump it a lot before I got to where I knew I needed the brake.
Yeah.
And then finally it was. I just thought maybe it was, I didn't know what happened.
Obviously that's not the way you wanted it to go. What's the rest of the day and tomorrow look like for you?
Well, we can go over the truck and side by side and make sure everything's good. Yeah, that sucked. I knew something was wrong when, you know, I didn't have brakes, but I didn't know that the wheel was gonna fall off. That was I can just keep driving around tracks. We'll fix the brakes when we get back to the pits. Well, I made it back to the pit, but it was on a stretcher.
On a stretcher.
God. Yeah, we'll get it fixed, and I still feel good. I mean, we didn't have a bad lap time for like not having a truck that wouldn't turn.
That's
stop.
A weird problem, wasn't it? It wasn't like a normal thing.
We're still dumbfounded of what exactly happened, but we'll get it fixed and figured out and be ready for the race tomorrow. At least it happened in qualifying, not the race. That would really suck.
So where does that put you in qualifying? Like, how's that set
seventh.
You up for tomorrow?
Seventh. So I don't know whatever the invert is, but we're seventh. So I don't know. LeDuc was fastest, so whatever he drew for an invert, I'm not real sure. But it doesn't really matter anyway. Just go out there and put in good laps.
Well, that wraps up the first day here in Wisconsin. That is obviously not the way that you want things to go, but Kyle made the best of it. He didn't go into the wall. The only thing you can really do at this point is put it back together and get ready for the first day of racing tomorrow. So I guess we'll see you again tomorrow.